Today, I'm going to introduce you to bee trees. But first, let's recap other tree structures. We've previously covered binary search trees, which are ordered binary trees where each node may have a left and a right child. But as you can see here, binary search trees may become unbalanced and thus slow down operations. We've also discussed red-black trees, which take binary trees a step further. We learned that when inserting and deleting nodes, we do so in a predefined manner to keep the tree balanced with the height of big O of log n. Bee trees are similar to red-black trees in that they are balanced search trees. Except unlike red-black trees, which are binary in nature, bee tree nodes may have numerous children, not just two. Bee trees are well suited for database systems and are designed to handle a large volume of data. As such, the goal of bee tree algorithms is to reduce disk operations. Generally speaking, the number of disk operations is proportional to the tree's height. Bee trees have a runtime of big O of log n for many operations. The height of a bee tree can be much less than red-black trees based on their branching factor, which is the number of children at each node. Lastly, it's important to note that because the data volume is very large, it may not all fit into a computer's primary memory, and that is why we try to reduce disk operations. Quick sidebar, remember that a computer has both primary memory and secondary storage. Primary memory, called random access memory or RAM, is made from silicon memory chips and is very fast but expensive. Secondary storage may either be a disk or more likely a solid state device. Secondary storage is cheaper but slow, and a computer will have much more of it than RAM. Because bee tree applications have a large amount of data, most of it will likely be in secondary storage. The application will load specific portions of the data, or pages, into RAM when it needs it. And this is why bee trees are useful, because they limit disk operations, which are much slower than RAM. Let's explore this further with an actual tree. It's common for a bee tree node to be roughly the same size as a disk page. For example, the node highlighted in red is similar in size as a page. We'll also assume that the root itself is kept in main memory. Let's say we want to find the key with the value of 47. We'd examine the root, determine it's not there, and load the right node from secondary storage into memory, since 47 is greater than the key in the root. We then examine the keys in this node. We don't care as much that we need to potentially examine a large number of keys, because this is still likely faster than loading from secondary storage. We determine 47 is not in this node, so we load another node into memory and find the key we're looking for. In total, we made two disk reads. I'm going to cut the video here, and in the next one, we'll discuss the properties that bee trees must follow. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe.